Gentlemen, live from the dark, deep recesses of your mind, this is an update thing, video, audio thing.
We come up with some Gone Cactar podcast or something like that.
Crapcast, more like. Okay, let's go. First of all, welcome Gone Games, first of all.
Welcome, hi, folks.
Fellow Let's Player extraordinaire, I am Fighting Cactar General all around. There's no other way to put it, God.
Guest trap failing.
Hey, everyone has their flaws. Mine happen to involve poisonous gas. No fart jokes will be tolerated in the next however long this video is.
No.
There will be no fart jokes. Okay, first of all, the first part of our thing, we're going to be discussing what we've been doing in the past week. So, go ahead, you start, I will follow.
Well, the first thing I've just done is been nearly enough walked up by a cactar for this, but never mind. Today I've been, like, showing my little brother and showing other people in my town. Some of the Let's Plays out who do it like Let's Play like I do. I've been playing a lot of Ocarina of Time, actually. And I've been doing... I've recorded some more Mario as well.
All right. So, shall I go? What I did?
Might as well.
Went and saw Iron Man 3, which was pretty good. Go see it. Recommendation. Go see that film. It's pretty good.
People force that upon you if you don't see it, basically.
I will destroy anyone who has yet to see this film. Ordered my 3DS, which is going to come here. It's going to be awesome. And Fire Emblem. Ocarina of Time 3D. Well, what can I say? It looks cool.
I said this to you. You said, I don't want a 3DS. It looks expensive. I said, Ocarina of Time is a good enough reason.
It was very much a good enough reason. So, that happened. I ordered my Buck ticket. Those of you who know what Buck is, you know where I'm going to be in August 23rd and 25th. I'm going to be in Manchester. Just doing what I do best, being awesome.
Not to get killed by people from Yorkshire.
Hey, no, I'll be in Lancashire. Well, Greater Manchester County.
Well, just stay away from our side.
You don't even know what Buck is. If you look at my Skype picture and you'll and think of a convention full of those people.
Yeah, I get what Buck is. I've had people moaning about it from college going on about it.
What do you mean?
It's one of those My Little Pony convention things, isn't it?
That it is.
Yeah.
Go and watch it. Don't judge it before you've seen the show.
I have seen the show. I got forced by my little sister to see the show.
Well, your sister is a great human being.
My sister is 11 and she's almost as tall as me. I'm not generally a short person either. It's just...
No. Well, okay. What else have I been doing?
You've not finished Resident Evil 2 yet.
I still have yet to do that. I have yet to do any more recording because I've got... for the next few months, I probably won't be doing recording because I've got exams, so...
Yeah, but I'm still going to be wanting to do that Resident Evil thing for you, and I've still planned... I'm not sure if I'm going to be doing the Strange Game or not or something else, but... This is an update. I'm going to be doing Earthworm Jim soon, folks.
Earthworm. Sorry. Whenever I hear that they play that game, I always the theme blasts through my head.
That's pretty much why I'm actually asking you to go on it with me.
Why the fuck not? I played the game a little bit and then I was like, this is ages ago, and I put it down and I never finished it. And then I watched the show and I was like, Christ, this looks awesome. Why haven't I played the game? And then I picked it up and I realized, holy shit, this game can be pretty hard sometimes.
That's why it's going to be in, like, that's another thing. Basically, I'm going to... just before people just say, oh, you're nicking Leviathan's idea, it was actually my idea to use a Friday for an odd game. It's just Leviathan called it something else. Mine's going to be, like, Funky Friday, which is something like that.
I've already recommended a game for you to do.
Which, I can't remember.
It was the remake of Final Fantasy VI.
Oh, yeah, the,
the entirely rewritten dialogue and sprite-based... MLP Final Fantasy VI Remake, which is hype. Hype as shit.
You know, I might do that, but I don't, because I'm waiting until my sister goes, oh, he didn't like My Little Pony.
Oh, you will be assimilated into the herd, and I will make sure of its eventual arrival. You will be assimilated. That's what it is.
Remember, I've still got a sword.
You've still got a what?
I've still got a very real master sword.
I have one of them. Got one of them on my wall. Okay, so that's the update from my end. Anything specific, like, in the world you want to discuss?
No, I don't know. E3's coming up soon.
Oh yeah, Nintendo pulling out of E3, haven't they? They've
Nope.
said
Nope.
that they
Rumor.
haven't.
False
They're not doing
rumor.
a conference. That's what they're doing. Is that it?
No, what it was is they're not doing a proper press conference like they normally do, but people thought they pulled out completely. It's a rumor. They haven't.
Oh wow. A lot of people saying this is the end of E3. It's not. It's really not. E3 is going to keep going despite
I
Nintendo.
remember
And it's.
watching last year's E3 when they were about the Wii U. I had like 2 8-packs of Pepsi cans, like a load of chocolate and like a load of crisps, and I was just sat there for 4 whole days just watching the streams.
Jesus. I was like, so yeah, it's not gonna die. Calm down. Keep calm. It won't die. The problem, like, the reason more than likely Nintendo have pulled out is because Microsoft and Sony are gonna get more coverage because they're announcing the PS4 and whatever the new Xbox is gonna be called, and the Wii U has already been announced and released. So, what, how are Nintendo in any way gonna top that? It's not gonna happen.
You do realize they've got the things I know because I get the Nintendo magazine. The things that they've got up the sleeve, the Xbox. No, because there's been a lot of bad press about the new Xbox and the PlayStation because of the game sticking thingy.
The games, what?
Do you remember when I said about the reason why I wouldn't buy a PlayStation 4? Because once you put a game and it's stuck to that system.
Really?
Yeah, a lot of people aren't buying them because of that, and I think the Xbox is the same thing.
Oh, fuck that sound.
I
So
think it's just.
the used game market is going to completely die?
Well, no, because people won't buy them and will buy Nintendo. Look, it's basically to avoid piracy, which not really going to help.
I swear to God, every time that since this is avoiding piracy, DRM didn't. Everyone hates when DRM fucks you over, and just the only real way you really combat piracy is through something like Steam, I suppose, which combats piracy relatively well.
The thing is, even if they try using it that way, it only takes someone to make an emulator for something like that, especially seeing as there's not exactly motion controlled systems. And
Exactly.
they've lost it anyway, really.
Exactly. So that's E3. That's pretty much it for
But some of
E3.
the games that Nintendo are actually planning actually sound pretty decent, so.
Such as.
Such as Professor Layton and Space of Phoenix, right?
That shit
Phoenix
looks so hyped.
Ace Attorney 5.
That looks so hyped, ladies and gentlemen. I have a one problem with the trailer for that, which I've explained to you, but I'll explain to the rest of you. When in that trailer, the first thing he says is, "I accuse you of being a witch because you know the contents of a book without having actually read it." I'm thinking this entire time, probably used Wikipedia.
Well,
That's how I learn the
it
plot of
doesn't.
everything.
To be fair, that town isn't exactly. When you see what the town's like, it doesn't exactly look like you'd be able to use a computer in that.
Doesn't have a solid internet connection, does it? You don't expect Wi-Fi in that area or BT Infinity. You've got BT Infinity. That's the problem. That's what the world of Professor Layton needs is BT Infinity.
That's the one thing. I mean, when there were people saying it's not, might not come over, like it better bloody come over, otherwise I'm going to go hit up the offices and kill them.
Exactly.
Just purely because I think that'd be a good mix between them two.
Yeah. I still think it's weird because, like, didn't you have, like, you had mobiles
In Ace
Phoenix
Attorney,
Wright,
yeah.
it's relatively modern.
You had like a computer system where, in the third case in the first game, would you get the photos off and everything?
Exactly.
The
And
thing
you
is.
had the, in the third game when you were, sorting out there was, like, there were cameras and you had to sort
You mean
out
the
stuff.
Master Mask case?
Yeah, I do mean the Master Mask case. I did not like that case. It was my least favorite of that entire game.
That's another update we should probably. I'm planning on doing a lot of our Ace Attorney review as well.
I do like Phoenix Wright as a game series. It's a very good idea.
I own every single available game on both Ace Attorney and Professor Layton. I haven't finished all Professor Layton yet, but I've done the Ace Attorney series.
I've Ace Attorney. I have Trials and Tribulations. I've played the original Ace Attorney. And I've got Apollo Justice, which is quite good.
Trials is my favourite though.
Trials is the best. It does have quite a good story, and it has a story that runs throughout. So yeah, that's we've gone through E3 and
The Ace Attorney and
Nintendo and Ace Attorney. So we've done quite a bit in this episode. One last thing before we round this off. BioShock Infinite was released recently. And one of the major talking points of BioShock Infinite is, have you played BioShock Infinite first of all?
We've talked about this. We me and Lightman and Chase Wolf and Leviathan have been trying to do recording this so many times that everything kept going wrong. Like on the stream, and we'd either have to ban someone, there'd be lag, or someone would pop off, someone would go fall asleep, or someone would disappear.
Uno secondo. I will be back in a minute.
But, yeah, folks, I'm actually trying to get Bioshock myself, but one's a bit new. But, yeah, I don't think, Kat, you'll probably see this later, fighting, but you made the gas trap mistake, I made the shotgun trap mistake.
To the viewers, I now have a cup of tea, and a massive gap in the video where absolutely nothing is happening.
Actually, I've been talking
for
the
video. We'll
probably
have to edit this at one point.
Actually, you won't, because I've actually been talking for the video while you were gone.
Oh, you've been talking. Fantastic. That's great.
What is it with you and tea every time I have a drink, like a cup of tea, tea, cup of tea?
Because I'm southern. It's what we do.
You're like me with Coke.
Oh, see, I drink Yorkshire tea. I drink tea from your lands.
It's funny because there's a village in my town, and you can actually buy tea from there. It's their brand of tea, I'm not even kidding.
Awesome.
Like Melton tea or something like that.
Safe. Right.
But
Okay, so Bioshock Infinite. I have played it, which it's...
Which version have you played?
I played the Xbox version.
Get the PC version, the graphics are tons better.
Well, my PC doesn't really run that well, unfortunately. Runs alright. It just doesn't, it runs alright, but it doesn't particularly, run games well.
In other words, it's pretty crap.
Yeah. Tricky face.
Alright, are we going to end this here, because I am getting tired.
Alright, okay. That was it. Ladies and gentlemen, good night and good luck and such. Alright, bye.
Bye, folks.